His glory fills this place. Everlasting Father, you never fail. He is really God. Friends, I want to say God bless you. May the Lord make his face shine upon your life. And I believe that you are living in the most critical hour where God is about to make his face shine in your life and is about to do great things that he has never done before. This is an hour of change, an hour of miracles, an hour of signs and wonders. And I want you to understand that God is about to do something bigger and something great in your lives. Today, God has spoken to me in the early morning and he said to me, my son, I want you to tell my people that I'm ready. I want you to tell them that I'm about to change their lives and that I'm about to do great things in them. That no eye have seen, no ear have heard, neither come to the mind of man that which the Lord has prepared for them that love him. If you love God in this season, be ready for great things. If you love God, be ready for mighty signs and wonders, miracles. God has never changed. He is always the same. You know, I want to encourage you today because I know you may be going through tough times. You may be going through challenges and tough circumstances. The Bible says many are the afflictions of a righteous man, but the Lord will redeem them, him unto them all. I want to say each and every challenge that is coming in your life, it has never come for your own destruction, but it is always bringing about the plan of God in your life. So it comes with promotion. Every time you see a challenge, just understand the Lord wants to promote me. The Bible says that sit in my right hand, I'll make your enemies thy footstool. Meaning that your enemies are the stepping stone towards your destination. So every time you see opposition coming, just know God wants to promote you. That when God is promoting you, then it means that you will step upon your enemies to get into the next level of life. So whatever that you are facing right now, whether it be a challenge, whatever it is, just understand that God is ready to promote your life and God is ready to change you. You are about to become one of the greatest things that have ever happened on planet Earth. In that book of Ezra, in Ezra number 3, verse number 10, the Bible says there that when the laying of foundation was done, when the foundation was laid, the builders talked to the priests and told the priests that right now you may lay, you may take the harps, take the timbrels and the guitars and begin to praise the Lord because the foundation has been laid. The Bible says the whole Israel, the whole priest and everybody in Israel, they began to worship God. They began to praise the Lord because the foundation of the temple was laid. Those who saw the temple that was before this one, the former temple, and they saw the foundation of the latter temple was being formed, the Bible says they began to cry. They began to weep, thinking about how was the last temple looking alike. And they, as the prophet Haggai spoke and said, for the glory in this latter house will be greater than the glory in the former. Meaning that the temple that was going to be built, it was going to be the most better temple than ever the temple that was destroyed by the enemy. Now, family, I want you to see something in this thing. At the laying of foundation, there were already celebrations. When they laid the foundation, the Bible said they began to cry and celebrate because the foundation was laid. Now, God spoke to me. He said, I want to tell my children that I have laid their foundation. And they have to learn to praise me in the foundation phase. Many of us today, we don't want to praise in the foundation phase. We don't want to give thanks in the foundation phase. We want to see the completion of the building process before we can give praise, before we can give glory to God. We want to see God doing all of it and completing it before we can say, God, we thank you. God, you have done it again. But the Bible says the children of Israel, they never waited for the building of the temple to be complete. But at the laying of foundation, they took time to rejoice. They took time to pray and they took time to appreciate God because the temple foundation was laid. The Bible says each neighbor was celebrating. They were crying out loud. They were jubilating to the Lord because only the foundation was laid. They knew that the God who had helped them to lay the foundation was also going to help them to complete the building. So they knew that as long as the foundation is laid, we don't worry about the finishing process, because we know that at the laying of foundation, there is a guarantee that if this foundation be laid, the God who has laid this foundation will surely complete this building process. They understood that God would never allow them to have a foundation and not complete the building of their temple. I want to say to you right now, you may be going through a lot of challenges. You may be going through tough times, but God has laid the foundation of success in your life. God has laid the foundation of victory in your life. You are no longer where you were before. When you are looking at your life right now, you can see the difference. You can see the difference between last year and this year. You can see the difference between the past 5 years and today. You can see the difference between the past 10 years and today. You were sick before, now you are healed. Before, you didn't have even a single cent, but now you have just that small money. There is an improvement from yesterday to today. So you know that at least if God managed to do this improvement, it means he has laid the foundation in my life. You may not be there already, but at least you are no longer where you were. You have to praise God in that foundation phase. You have to thank God that he has laid the foundation of success. You are no longer sick. You are healed. You are no longer broke anymore. At least you have a little cent in you. That alone is a sign that God is taking you further and further every day. You don't have to cry anymore. You just have to say thank you, the Lord. Some of you, you were once on a deathbed. You were sleeping and you thought you were about to die. But today you are alive and you are walking again. That is a sign of itself that God has laid the foundations in your life. So I want to say to you today, praise the Lord in the foundation phase. When God has laid the foundation, it is a sign that for sure and for real, he will complete the building. I was telling somebody, I said, now I'm in a position in my life where I do not care what happens, because I can see the foundation has been laid and my greatness can never be postponed, because the God who has begun a good work in me is faithful that he will bring it unto completion. God, the Bible says, God is not an unjust man that he forget our labor of love. He knows our very works, and he will surely in due time give us what is due to us. So friends, I want to say to you, may the Lord bless you. May the Lord give you the strength to praise him and to worship him in the foundation phase. Give thanks in the foundation phase, because God has laid your foundation. You are about to succeed. You are about to be great. The foundation of that vision has been laid. The foundation of that dream has been laid. The foundation of that company, that organization, that ministry has been laid. Now be courageous. Continue, because God is on your side. God has already made it happen for you. I want to pray for you right now. Maybe you've been losing strength. Maybe you've been trying to give up in life. I want to say to you, do not give up anytime, because something big is about to happen. Something great is about to happen in your life. So do not give up. It is about to go down. It is about to be the biggest time of your lives. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray right now for my friend. They want to praise you in the foundation phase. They want to worship you in the foundation phase. Be healed. Be delivered from the spirit of depression. Be delivered from the spirit of stress. In the name of Jesus. In the blood of Jesus Christ. My friend, praise the Lord in that foundation phase. Praise the Lord in that small blessing. Praise the Lord in that small house. Praise the Lord in that small car. It's about to happen in your life. Be delivered. Be delivered. Be set free. 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 I can see you delivered right now. I can see you delivered in the blood of Jesus. Father, bless them right now. Increase them right now. Give them the strength to continue. For young men utterly fall, but them that wait upon the Lord, you will renew their strength. To mount up and fly like eagles and run, never be weary. Be delivered. Your family be delivered. Your life be delivered. It's your time to prosper. It's your time to increase in Jesus' name. My friend, I want to say to you, the God who has begun a good work in your life is faithful, and he's going to bring it unto completion. May the Lord bless you. My name is Yamkela Joseph. Until I see you next time. Shalom, shalom.